the stone-hearted response from the NIA is a blot on our regulatory apparatus and the country at large. In the Delhi violence, we saw how the Delhi police tried to stop ambulances from reaching the hospital, even as critically wounded people were in need of urgent medical care. We saw how the Delhi police systematically ignored desperate calls from the violence affected. This unique cruelty and uncaring has been extended to the investigations they are conducting at the moment. It displays an utter lack of common understanding when it opposed the bail pleas of Jamia Millia Islamia student Safura Zagar, stating that 39 deliveries have been made in Delhi prisons in the last 10 years as proof that women can deliver in jail. Women detainees can deliver in jail. That's what he said. They didn't even take into consideration that we are living in pandemic times. Coming to the use and misuse of information, we know how COVID-19 pandemic has been used to stifle voices, yours, ours. It has been used to provide cover to the manufacture of fake news and the deployment of information in skewed ways. Inspired leaks to the media were the early evidence, and one of the jailed women activists even went to court to allege the selective leaking of information by the police. In its response, the police denied the accusation and claimed that the information it put out on its WhatsApp group was only by way of clarification and correction. But the fact is that the Delhi has an official WhatsApp group that it has used strategically at all times. The Delhi police are unspooling a lot of data from private sources like phones and laptops, just as the Pune police had done before them. Umar Khalid himself, before he was jailed, had written to the Delhi police S.N. Srivastava, alleging that the special cell investigators were putting pressure on his acquaintances to implicate him in the case. Is this then the case that coerced evidence garnered by the special cell away from the public gaze is being used to jail people in the absence of real evidence, charging them of conspiracies against the state, murder and attempts of murder? If that is the case, then we are living in dystopian times and we should all be conscious of this. Information is also being used by the police in dodgy ways to develop a believable narrative with the help of mainstream media. It is to be hoped that once Khalid is freed from his present troubles, he will have the mind space to sue these unscrupulous vendors of lies, fake news, half-truths, who don't think twice about passing off a public conversation as a private chat in order to window dress their toxic news. The head of the police, Delhi police, S.N. Srivastava, says more cases have been filed against Hindus than Muslims in the Delhi riots investigation to establish its lack of bias. He says nothing about why only leaders, prominent activists, and very promising students of one side have invited WAPA charges. Kapil Mishra, let us remember, is still a free man, as also Anurag Thakur and Parvesh Verma. Let us not forget that Special Commissioner, Crime and Economics Offences Wing of Delhi Police, Praveer Ranjan, had on July 8th written a special instruction to supervisory officers, ACPs, DCPs, SIT and additional CP crime headquarters to guide the investigating officers so that they take due care, and I quote him, due care and precaution, close quote, to avoid Hindu resentment, close quote, while making arrests in the cases arising from the riots. I would like to end by observing that when the police speak of Hindu resentment, remember they are being economical with the truth. Millions upon millions of Hindus in this country, like Indians, like Sikhs, like Buddhists, like Christians, everywhere, want nothing more than peace, justice, and the capacity to lead fulfilled lives. The country wants nothing less than a fair investigation into the Delhi violence.